Mr. Speaker, honourable members, prayers. Almighty God, we humbly beseech thee to look with favour upon this youth in part parliament. Grant that it may perform its high duty as to thy sight. Give divine guidance to the founder and the speaker of this youth parliament. Endow members of parliament in discernment and vision, integrity and courage, that through the labors of this youth parliament, the interests and wishes of the members may be what we truly serve, and thy good purposes for the common human life be realized in our midst. O God, grant us the vision of this youth parliament, fair as it may be, the fraternity of righteousness, where man shall wrong his neighbor, the fraternity of plenty, where evil and poverty shall be done away with, the fraternity of brotherhood, where all success shall be founded in service, and honor shall be given to the deserving, the fraternity of peace, where the new parliament shall rest in the will of its members, and the love for the common good. Bless the efforts of those who struggle to make this vision a living reality. Inspire and strengthen our people that they may give time, thought and sacrifice to speak the day of the coming beauty of this youth impact parliament, voter regime, and Ghana. Amen. 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 Honourable members, moving to item 2 on the order paper. Honourable members, I'm glad to have this House reconvene for the first sitting in this second session, telling the fourth parliamentary season of this first parliament. Honourable members, I believe that Christmas break was very resourceful, enlightening, and of course, very relaxing. Yes, this Christmas was also very good for me. We needed the House to bring for such a long time for members to come in bigger and stronger. I'm very sure we have more court budgets in the House. Yes. So, honourable members, on behalf of leadership and myself, I want to use this opportunity to welcome you to today's sitting, and I hope you enjoy whatever will go on. Thank you very much. Honourable members, moving to item 3 on the order paper. Communication of the founders. Honourable members, as you know, the founders are Mr. Millicent, the two co-founders, Mr. Ahianu and Mr. The founders wish to communicate to the House that they are happy the House is progressing. They have seen that the House has already started the virtual seminar series, and then it's already having this court parliamentary season since establishment. Other youth parliaments have not even reached that size. Some have not even met the goal of last year, but we are already reaching this place. Let's all go funding. They want to use this opportunity to encourage you to keep on pushing hard, as this House has more opportunities for you to harness. So on behalf of the founders, I want to use this opportunity to congratulate you for being here and also to tell you to ensure that this House grows. As this House grows, you will also grow. Honourable members, I thank you very much. Honourable members, moving to item 4, adoption of order paper. The floor is open for amendments to the order paper for the day. Honourable members, any submission? In the absence of any submission, can an honourable member business to be transacted for today's meeting. Yes, Honorable Second Deputy, Majority Leader.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
Thank you very much, Honourable Member. A seconder. Yes, Honourable Minority Chief.
Right, Honourable Speaker. I second for the adoption of the
Okay. You second for the adoption. Can you please second the motion for the adoption of the Honourable?
I second the motion for the adoption of the Honourable.
Thank you very much. Honourable members, motion moved and seconded for the other paper. I now put the question to the House. All honourable members in favour that the items of the other paper be business be transacted for this, say aye. Not in favour, say nay. The ayes have it, the motion carries. Therefore, this other paper shall stand as business to be transacted for this. Honourable members, it is time for the official introduction of members. Today, I would like to humbly start from my beautiful clerks seated in front of me. If the mic can be handed over to them, they will introduce themselves. We have some acting among them, so if they don't mention their designation, they are acting in that capacity. Yes, please proceed.
I'm Quashie, Millicent, Morkor, Deputy Clerk of Operations Plans, Acting Clerk for the Group.
My name is Anthony Isabella, Acting Deputy Clerk of Publicity.
Thank you.
My name is Augustine Agbavor, Acting Deputy Clerk of Operations.
Thank you.
Justina.
Thank you very much. Majority Leadership, kindly introduce yourself to the House with all the ingredients you want to add to it for the records.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I respond to the name Selorm, Deputy Majority Leader of the Legislature House, by acting Majority Leader, Chairman. Thank you.
Oh, please. I'm very sure you have some information before. Let us see.
Okay, former Vice Public Relations Officer to the HTS at the project. And then Deputy Clerk to the HTS at the project as well.
Thank you very much. Next person.
My name is Fix myself, the acting deputy manager. Our former teacher secretary, former speaker of the Parliamentary Assembly, director of my political business.
Yes, please speak a little louder so that you can have it more on the
records. My name is myself. I'm the acting director of the Republic. I was a former teacher secretary and also the speaker of the Parliamentary General Assembly, director of the SRP.
Thank you very much, and next is.
Thank you, Reverend. My name is Pontage Pedimon. The student of this global institution, the former General Secretary of Faculty of Engineering, former Faculty of Engineering Coordinator, former MP of SR Parliament, and then currently the SR Leaders. Thank you.
Currently, first organized faculty of advice and sciences.
chairman, and as you are sitting here, help my party of this yes, sir. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Eric. Gallant and Maria.
twice I come.
No political introduction. We are assumed we have not ever.
which means that your brother could be there, your sister could be there. You have to be a citizen of Ghana to be a Ghana police. So if you're a citizen of Ghana, police in Ghanaians, these in Ghanaians, the Ghanaians that pay your salaries, the Ghanaians that pay for your uniforms, the Ghanaians that pay for the weapons you carry, the Ghanaians that pay for the vehicles you use, the Ghanaians that pay for the very road you drive those vehicles on. If you are policing these Ghanaians, should you not do so with a little bit of respect? Indeed, no one is saying that the police do not have power or authority. They do. But that is where we have some problems. In the Criminal Procedure Code of 1960, there is a section that tells the police to arrest you without warrants. Indeed, the police should not be able to walk up to anybody in this country to say that they are arresting a person without warrants. Before you arrest someone, there must be a warrant stating the crime for which you arrest the person. And when you get there, you also need to give the person his rights. In other jurisdictions, it's called in mirror rights, where they tell you you have the right to remain silent. Anything you say kind of will be used against you in the court of law. You have the right to an attorney. If you cannot provide one, the state will provide one for you. When was the last time you heard a police say these words to someone you want to arrest? It is sad and appalling. Almost to the extent that it seems there is something called an abuse of power in their standard. But the Criminal Procedure Code of 1960, Section 10, says arrest without warrant. And this concerns us. It says a police officer may arrest without warrant any person who A, commits an offense in his presence. Next, if you are committing an offense in the presence of the police can arrest you without warrant. Obstruct a police officer in the execution of his duty. So a police officer is chasing a criminal to arrest a criminal, and then you obstruct the police officer. The police officer has the right to arrest him. It makes perfect sense. Has escaped or attempts to escape from lawful custody. So you have become a fugitive. The police officer has the right to arrest him. Have in his possession any implement adapted or intended for use in an unlawful end. So that's to say that the realize that you are going to cause harm, the police officer has the right to arrest you. However, there is a place where it says a police officer may arrest without any warrant a person he suspects upon reasonable grounds. Who determines the reasonable grounds? Now that is a question we need to think about. Who determines the reasonable grounds? Why am I bringing this up? Not long ago, another citizen of Ghana was arrested because he displayed a photograph of a gun on social media. I don't know how many are familiar with this, but I found that highly illogical. Yes, indeed, there is a law for that. And that law is in Section 206 of the Criminal Code. You see, you cannot, without lawful authority, carry a weapon. Or, without lawful authority, be displayed a weapon. And if you read Section 206, you will see that there are several statements out there in there that will tell you that anything at all can be an offensive weapon. For example, Clause 4 of Section 206 says, in this section, offensive weapon means an article made or adapted for use for causing injury to a person or intended by the person having it with him for such use by him. So basically, I'm holding a pen. You know, someone can actually commit murder with a pen. So would we consider a pen an offensive weapon? I play video games. I like the guns I see. I pick one of the photos of the gun and I use it as a profile picture, a display picture, anything. Should that cause for my arrest? It cause for my this matter. Because in any event, these things are called, these things fall under something they call misdemeanor. Now, more recently, something more drastic has happened. You see, under President Rowling, two people, with Fulbright Junior and one other guy, the name of the administration, were arrested for alleging that the then first lady had indulged in some illegalities. Let me put it that way. They seized rationing. Later they were sent to the they were in prison. But they were not in prison because of the criminal idea, but they were in prison because of contempt of court. And even more recently, the Tupac himself confirmed that. But we had a problem with the criminal idea because we felt that it was punishing speech. It was criminalizing speech. President Agbavor, at the time, the Attorney General of Ghana, under His Excellency President Jonathan Kufuor. So, together with the Jonathan Kufuor administration, the criminal libel law was repealed. However, Section 208 of the criminal code was maintained. What is Section 208 of the criminal code? Because that is what the police are using today to arrest people. Not all of it makes sense anyway. And for the new IGP, let me quickly just say this. I have seen two changes in the police service that I personally would commend the new IGP for. One, during the recruitment, the 2021 police recruitment, the police service offered their recruits a shared area so that they could sit, and then they offer them water. Believe me, in my very short life, I have not seen that done in Ghana. So they deserve some commendation for that. The second time I felt these people deserve some commendation is when the driver unions went on strike and the police delivered buses to cut the passengers to their various workplaces. I thought that was a very beautiful gesture the police should do that. Because that then brings the meaning, police is your friend, to light. It's not just speech anymore, it's not just talk anymore. It's now action. However, arresting people in something that could be considered a civil matter, if I publish false news about any member here, Mr. Speaker, it is up to the person to take civil action against me, one, or two, to even avoid going to court. If you believe that what I have published is false, what you do is to present the truth to the Ghanaian people through what we call a rejoinder. Now, by you presenting that truth, it would even put my credibility at stake. Which means that tomorrow, should I publish any other story, nobody will take me seriously because I have already published what? A false story. Indeed, if you do not want to go about it that way, you can always file a civil case in court. Where it will be between me and you. And if the court will find the guilty party some hefty sum of money that the person will not think about publishing another false story. Presently, as we speak, Lighthouse Chapel that Bishop Agbavor built is in court suing the fourth estate, Manasseh Azuri's newspaper. They are in court now, as we speak. The police didn't have to go and arrest Manasseh Azuri. Now, when they go to court, Manasseh Azuri would now have the benefit to present his evidence to the court, and then Lighthouse also present their evidence to the court. In a they say anybody who publishes or reproduces any statement, rumor or report, which is likely to cause fear and alarm to the public, or disturb the public peace, knowing or having reason to believe that the statement, rumor or report is false, such a person is guilty of a misdemeanor. Now, people are being arrested Rambo style for a simple matter of misdemeanor. In this our country, the youth of today, we need to remember, because it is some of us that will find ourselves tomorrow in the police service, that the police service is no longer the police force. It is no longer the police force under the colonial government, where blacks will be told to go and shoot their fellow blacks to protect the whites. We are not in that era anymore. You do not go arresting people before you think of a child to give them. I noticed that the motion for today's debate is Ghanaian youth should seek knowledge over power. I will try as much as possible to not mention anything about the motion. But ask yourself, the behavior of our law enforcement agencies, are these knowledge-based or power-based? It is about time the youth of Ghana make an impact everywhere we find ourselves. Before I end it, I would like to ask one question. Now, I have enormous respect for the police, which is why I would commend them for acts that they do that I feel is right. But let us take this scenario. You see a citizen, you are a police officer, just assume you are a police officer, and then you see a citizen that you've been asked to go and arrest. Which means you know why you are going to arrest the person. Now you come to the person. You haven't mentioned to the person he's under arrest. You haven't read the person is right. You haven't even shown the person a warrant. For all we know, that might not even be the person you are supposed to be arresting. Are we getting it? Now, why you go there to arrest this person? You try to just judge or accost the person, if I may say. The person resists and then beats you up. You are a police officer. You try to accost the person. Now the person resists the arrest and then beats you up. Now that would be a problem. That would be an answer in a police officer. But who caused it? Because today, we are hearing that police, men in uniform, actually running vehicles. They are in police uniforms and they are running vehicles on the way. That person would assume that, well, if you're a proper police, you would have gone, you would have arrested me by due process. You would have arrested me by what we call rules of engagement. You didn't do any of that. So then the person is, who is to blame should a citizen assault such a police officer? Let's think about this, and then let's think about what we do to our dear mother. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Private business.
If we move to page 3 of the pamphlet, Honorable Newman, please give me about our meeting. Just a little bit. If you look at page 3, you can see that we have a list of nominated officers. So this is what we are going to do. When the person is around, we'll take the name, the automatically right to write. When the person is not around, for the nominated ones, not the occupied, when the person is not around, we'll replace it immediately and then we proceed. Is the house in favor? If the house is in favor, say aye. Not in favor, say nay. So we are accordingly proceed with that order. Deputy Majority Leader Selorm present, practical. Deputy Majority Leader Hubert present, practical. Majority Chief Whip, Wanda Nicodemus Dancy. He came around. Yes, he rectified. Minority Chief Whip, Godwin Miao Quashie present, practical. First Deputy Majority Chief Whip, present, ratified. First Deputy Minority Chief Roger. It's not around. So we need a quick replacement. Honorable Godwin Gossip, do you want to step in that capacity? Do you want to step in that capacity as our First Deputy Minority Chief? No, please. Is there anyone who wants to step in that capacity? Oh, I think the house is under the master of right. Honorable Felix, please join me in the caucus. Please come and join me in the caucus. Yes.
My
okay, Honorable Gossip, you like the chairperson? I want to take that from you and give the leadership position. Okay, so honorable members, pending approval with respect to the changes, honorable Gossip and Amegashie-Viglo stands as our first deputy majority whip. Second deputy majority whip, Brother Agbavor. She's not here. I intentionally reserved the second deputy positions for the feminine gender to ensure that we go in consonance with that pledge to the goals. So, if the House would allow, should we nullify or should we give her another chance?
Yes.
Okay, so only for that portfolio. So she'll be given another opportunity to present herself. If she's not around, whichever female is around, then we'll proceed. Second deputy minority queen, Agesta Kake. Agesta, you are here. Ratified. Okay, so honorable members, this is the leadership of the house. And if you have been ratified, that means your status has been changed from nominated to occupied. All honorable members in favor of the new leadership of the House, say aye. Not in favor, say nay. The ayes have the motion carries. Therefore, the leadership of the House is fully accepted. Honorable members, moving to the next part of business, which is commencement of private business. Questions to the House, statements, and petition. First, the Deputy Speaker to take the chair. Second, let's speak out to the chair.
Honourable Speaker, thank you very much for the opportunity. Honourable members, commencement of private business, statements, questions, petitions, anything you want to know concerning the house, any questions you have, me here or out, you have the chance to increase your phone. Thank you very much. Honourable Body.
Yeah.
what is happening over here so that if there's any support for it, whatever they can do for us, they will do it. So I'll just pardon you to the house that in the due course you will hear from us. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
Thank you very much, on our members. Please, does anyone have any other thing? And the commencement of primary business, please. All right. Thank you all, members. Okay, honorable well,
Congrats. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
Knowledge that is being
Thank you, Honorable Selorm. Honorable members, I therefore want to put you to the House that I want an honorable member who can keep what give me the topic for our first seminar. Any honorable member without an English or a poll can remember the topic for our first virtual seminar. And if possible, our guest speaker. Any honorable member who equally good that without making reference to this or a poll, who have double of who have double identity. Honorable members, please don't check your comments. I'm watching you all. I want the topic for our first virtual seminar. And guest speaker. I will equally ask the question to you. So don't play this part. On all members, please, the topic for our first virtual seminar. On all God's sake, please, were you able to make this great affair?
No, please.
Thank you for referring to the standing orders. Indeed, both of the proceedings and official reports ought to be made available to the House. However, the answer department has not been mistaken. Even whenever we prepare our reports, we realize that the substantive amount of the amount, we have a lot of practice. The answer department is not always true. However, whoever writes to this issue, I think have the list of all the ministry rules over here, but they are not, as of now, ready to type the best technique as far as that. So the council department is not yet really on their feet to type it out and make it available. However, I wish that soon in the future, the substantive will be up to task. So for now, that is why we ensure that the video recordings, which are the media records of the House, are always available for reference. So those ones are properly kept. So that if in case the Hansa department is coming back to their feet, you can go and watch the video and type all those outstanding official reports to be presented at whatever is being ready. So I plead to the House to help me ensure that the Hansa department is back to its feet, the clerk table. And whenever they are back, we'll make the official reports. Whether or subsequent, and if you want the outstanding also, we welcome back for now. And I'll show you that we still have the reports communicated. Thank you very much. Questions, statements, and petitions. Any statement on any public matter, any issue of public importance, want to draw the attention to the House. Maybe they are the governments in the country, want to make a statement on it, or you have a parliamentary prayer, or you have a question about the House, or maybe a question of public importance, you can raise the question. And now we the floor is open. In the absence of any, okay, on our
thank you, Mr. Speaker. I respond to the editor of the acting member of the House. I am making a submission of the publicity of our citizens. And I thought we should go about to meet the editor. You all have, please forgive me, go over the country. You all have WhatsApp. That I will urge all honorable members here to be sharing the flyers and the information from the new parliamentary page to our various platforms. We can meet from your household, meet for your home, from any other platform. We just want to expand our reach. So, with that said, I urge you all to stop us from our business when it comes to our group.
Thank you very much. Honourable members, let's try and go inside the House. Honourable members.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. My name is Evans. I would like to make these remarks. Last time when we had our first which is let's say, a guest or if I tried this thing and you made a comment concerning the SRC publishing of writing article to Parliament concerning how being an article. For which I think we as a youth people of Parliament and very bright, if you could take like something happened that we the youth everybody is concerned about. We can equally ring our voice by using those channels that are facing the parliament or pass the legal bills so that our voice will also be heard. I think when we do that, we are opening up for those who even didn't know what we do over here, also open their eyes, know there is something going on over there. And I think we can also get a help from those people. I think that's what I want to say.
Honorable Godwin, is that a follow-up or correction? Please, this is information. This is correction. This is follow-up and point of order. I need to declare the international sign to assure you. So, if you want to follow up, no problem. But if it's not a follow-up, I have to speak with you before.
Okay.
It's a follow-up on the matter, on the same matter. Honorable Wilson.
Thank you, right on the Mr. Park. My name is Vixen. Mr. Speaker, you've been 3 senators now, and you yourself have over and able to this beautiful black parliament. I can recall that was last presented. I asked you if, I don't know how, what the character that you put in place to extend your answer for the institution. For instance, you asked NTC in the rest, because I've realized that the youth in black parliament. Sometime now, look at the time that you started this publicity. But if I'm playing, there's a government now. But I don't know what I should do. And I don't know what you are doing in Paris to bring more people, not only in Houston, but other platforms, other businesses. Because we are here to restore on certain issues that are for us. I don't know what mechanism you are putting in place to bring all this home for, not only in Houston, but other students.
Thank you. That means I want to speak on Ivan's matter before I take the floor, because I forget what I want to speak. I agree with Honorable Ivan that the House can equally debate issues and present a position paper to the National Parliament. And very soon we should get to that. However, I want to call on Honorable Members to help their business committee in submitting motions that we can debate for our citizens and topics that we can give to our guest speakers for our virtual seminars. I want to thank honorable members. Each person should come with a motion that we can debate at our citizens and a topic for our virtual leadership seminars, so that we can have a lot of bank for these motions and the topics. Okay. Now to speak on honorable service issue, talking about publicity. Yes, I've been trying my best and we have shared all the information. And speaking of honorable Dixon's issue, we have a lot of EDUC students over here. We have one NTC over here. I was expecting the in-house people, but they were not able to come. And I'm trying my best, so I can't do it alone. That is why I need your help. Let us come inside the house and bring people from the enclave to come and participate. I'm trying my best. I spoke to the federal president, the speaker of U.S. However, none of them is here. I wouldn't believe anyone, because after all, it's not like we pay them to come here. But they will benefit from it if they know the importance and their companies. So speak to your colleagues so that they will come and join us and let's make this house bigger and greater. I will see the follow-up of Honorable Godwin.
Thank you, Reverend. I think I'll make a follow-up on two issues.
Okay,
I'm not going to ask about the happiness in the country and how we as a youth have to react to it. We can all relate to the ongoing youth strike. I've observed that most of the youth, especially SRCs, not SRC or public, but SRC cannot or any leadership groups, you cannot do anything. You are just sitting down and you are waiting for parliamentarians and politicians to be jeopardizing with our colleagues. About 6 weeks now, they are not learning. They are just sitting down to go and come. Some of them are journalism. And this matter has become a political thing that the elections and the politicians are paid. So I think it is prudent that one day, when similar things happen, we as a good parliament, we can issue statements of those things. We can collaborate with a lot of new parliaments and issue statements so that they know that what is happening in the country, we then can talk about. Number 2 is
for Kindly speak into the mic, Mr.
Okay. On my second issue is the membership side. On our WhatsApp platform, there are a lot of people over there. The one in the office is in the non-cap. We don't know what is happening to them. So I think one of these days, we should have a meeting of the platform and decide if we want to stay or we want to leave. Because they are just adding to our members on the platform. And the only problem that we have here today, we have some of the members who think some of us are doing that. Yes, all go to class. It will be great for them to be here. But I think we should decide on what we should do with them. So, the leadership is there. The leadership of the house. We should organize meetings on our platforms and determine the way forward. I think we know that. Thank you.
Thank you very much. I'll take a follow-up from
Honorable
Wonder. Follow-up
from Honorable
Wonder.
Thank you. Thank you, Reverend Mr. Please, my name is Wonder. Yeah, the follow-up that I want to raise is about the issue that Honorable spoke about at the first in general. Looking at things in terms of hierarchy, really, that I don't think there is a connection between all the university or national institutions in Ghana that their SRC executives have a common platform, however, they share information on the way forward. So, all the good operation that it should be rather than groups, National Union of Ghana students. Yeah, so on that note, we can table something the founder department to be issued to them to do something about. But the issue, the current issue, as far as our friends are seen, they have. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Honorable Wilson.
Thank you very much, Mr. Mayor. My name is Excel. I want to say that we don't know what to put in our collection activity. And I want to suggest to you, I'll be at the time we can be able to get a tour so that we go to the end and make the whole thing better. Very attractive, because although only WhatsApp, it's not making the whole thing attractive. We wish to tell you today, they are going to do us, and we made them do and happy. They will have a everybody that organize them, so that the whole thing attractive. Same applies to it, and then we will do it. Thank you.
Thank you very much for that contribution. I would also like to contribute on the same issue. I compare with the one around the world. I will do anything to ensure that this house grows. Let me just say that I don't exactly believe in excess numbers. Because even in the video, only people are the ones that appreciate. And that is what the people will see. So for me, having even you guys who are here alone is not motivation for me. Only you also want to become the political science. I'm very happy with you. And one day, I know that this house will really be too cool that we have to decide if honorable members will be taking maybe entrance ticket and all this. The starting is always difficult. But when we get to the position that we have to pay the part, we would have regretted that they didn't join as early as possible. I want to tell you that we'll get there. Very soon this house will have plenty of funding that the identity will be KCS. KFC, not from your pockets, but from the donations that will come from people who believe in our visions. And we'll get it. So let's paint a very good picture and then go and campaign and give the gospel to them. And this is a free opportunity for you to tap in. And hopefully, you'll not regret my name. But I want to tell you that my heart is really happy. Just have you guys here, committed and dedicated. I want to thank you all for being here. For the video, and for viewers watching from afar, they will only see you. And one day, who knows, an appointment will come from this, a recommendation will come from this, a referral that they have seen you speaking on the floor, on sensitive issues, on volunteerism, not on something to be paid for. Secure you a better job. One of the members, let's get a question. One of the members, do this for the house right after the commencement of our. instance, I'll add the package one of the professionals to the community. So it has not been the rush, but before we will suspend the house, at the end of private business, I'd like us to listen to one of our co-founders before we suspend the house. So honourable members, the floor is still open. Questions, statements, and petitions. The honourable one that has seen.
Right, thank you very much for being in the next house. Yes, my name is Manga. So I want to ask, previously during the last meeting, we tabled some issues concerning funding.
Thank you very much. For the records, there is no support coming somewhere as of now. The honorable Ivan School was making provision for that, and I don't know how far. And I don't want to do it like because you said you support me, I'm impressed. No, I don't like that. If you want to support us from your heart. I don't have to push you to support us. So I'm trying my best. If you have any needs, let's go ahead and get them to really support us. And then hopefully things will work out. But as of now, the only source of funding is coming from me. Thank you very much. Any questions, statements? It's a follow-up. Okay. Please proceed.
Mr. Speaker, I think during one of my best, the name still remains in the Erasmus to me. During the last sitting,
Honorable, you have been put order by the deputy and the let's say you want to order, please.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I rise to put the order before. The deputy still remains.
Honorable, you have been put order by the second deputy speaker. Second deputy speaker, let me hear you want to order before I
thank you,
Mr.
Speaker. And I was
please use the microphone. You want your voice to be louder.
Thank you, Right Honorable Speaker. In the House, my name is Ahianu, my second deputy speaker in the House. Honorable member, those without any necessity, thank you very much.
Honorable, I think this point of order is sustained. Honorable, it seems point of order is overruled. Honorable to the procedure.
Thank you very much. This is my house. The name is Mr. Speaker, pertaining to the issue of funding, our last meeting resulted in certain means of acquiring funds to finance our meeting and our proceedings. Mr. Speaker, paramount of the issues we discussed, although we didn't settle on was continuous payment. I'm not going there. However, I want to draw our attention to other itineraries that we equally brought up, which was writing our sponsorship. I think you can recall, the House can recall, we decided to sort of set for some sponsorships to aid our sentence. Mr. Speaker, I think immediate effect, that is right from now, we should try and draft some sponsorships to certain personalities and reputable people and seek funding from them. I think going forward, that will let's go for that.
Thank you very much. I would like to hear from one of our members. The Honourable John Sabla, let's hear from you. Honourable John Sabla, can you come to where the second deputy speaker is so that you can show me the video? Yes.
Or a week or something. Just
so much, Honourable Member, for your submission. Honourable Members, the Honourable Member is more or less moving the motion that the House should levy itself to support the business of the day. I think I'm writing the House a follow-up. Let's hear a follow-up.
Thank you very much, Mr. Speaker. The House. Mr. Speaker, on the issue of supporting the finances, I think going back, that would be similar to the payment of dues, looking at it in a particular perspective. And we refer to the team partner to actually bring us a report on that, of which they did. However, a final consensus was not arrived at. Is this leader to that effect? Are we saying that we want to bring this deliberate over it now? Get a particular amount fixed as dues for members. If that is it, then I move that motion be moved by an honorable member. However, I think the Committee on Funding should still sit on this with a dues payment and other sources of income to facilitate our citizens. That would be the best way for let the Committee on Funding sit on it and then report to us for deliberation. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Honourable Members, we'll be forming sittings, we'll be forming committees. And I think we have committee on special budgets. I think they can write people that for us. But for now, before we comment and then we give them that tax, if you ask me, I want Honourable Members to just support me in their hearts. For now, I don't want to impose the cost to anyone for which you because of that is not coming. I change your presence than your financial support. That is why as of now, I don't really want to impose any amount. But the Honourable Members that at our last sitting moved a motion that opportunity be created for financial support. And that has been implemented separately, even on Facebook, Telegram, on our page. I'll share the link. That Honourable Members who wish to support can support through this number. And I stated the number there. So Honourable Members, if you ask me from your heart, whatever you want to support us with, do so. If you don't have any money outside, no problem, just come to us and we cherish it. But if you want to support, whatever money, support us. When the timing is right for this payment, we'll start. But for now, I believe you should support from your heart. No figure. Anyone who just wants to be, just help us. They are going to do it. And there was some people who are not going to give money, but they have needs. Connect us. Let's get those funds. So, the letter, if you know, the clerk department is there. Come and help us. Let's grab and let's send the letter. Whatever we do. But for now, support us any way you can. We are going to do. And I'm impressed. That is my ruling on this matter. Proceed. Okay, Honourable Brown, this one. The microphone to you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Speaker. My name is Honourable this one. So, the Agbavor House. I would like to move a follow-up on what Honourable Selorm has put before the House pertaining to the news. I think it will be very important and if we can adopt his idea with the news. Even when you want to move out to seek for sponsorship, they will ask you how much do you have yourself. You get it. So there are certain things that if you yourself you cannot finance, then you shouldn't expect outsiders to be helping you. So I think as a member, if you know that you are committed to a goal, you should be able to be committed in a financial aspect. Because there are certain things that money has to be used, other resources have to be used. So it will be more prudent if each member have to contribute in a financial aspect also. I think it will also benefit the House and going forward to ask for sponsorship. Also, they will know that this House, we are very serious and we are being committed in a financial aspect also, but not looking at what they can do to help us. That is my submission. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Honourable member, last submission on this matter. Honourable.
Thank you very much, Mr. Speaker. We have this last. I think it's the last question. Mr. Speaker, concerning what Honourable member said, is equally right in the sense that it is essential that we be committed towards the funding before we request the sponsorship. However, I wanted to be heard and be known that there is no necessity, no law or regulation that states that it has to be funded before you can seek sponsorship from any particular entity. In the sense that I'm not shoving what the honorable member said, but I'm encouraging that at least we commit to be funded. However, Mr. Speaker, I believe this is more or less like an NGO. This is more or less like a youth advocacy platform. And people who see our commitment and our contribution to governance will be ready to help in their little and best way. Mr. Speaker, so I see nothing that should hinder us, nothing that should militate against us from reaching out to people or others out there who are ready to support. Mr. Speaker, I for one, when you mentioned the fact that the number was placed on the platform, I for one, I'm not aware of it. I wasn't aware. I, because I was the one pushing for this very agenda, I would have contributed to this particular system, Mr. Speaker. For that, I apologize. However, members, we are waiting for the committee on funding their report. That is, as they are being instigated or innovated. However, honorable member, you are right. Let's commit to this funding. It's like you are being skeptical. You have to see a chair, you have to see a chair. That's the habit that is standing. You don't understand. Mrs. Speaker, waiting, waiting. Okay, Mrs. Speaker, to that effect, thank you.
Thank you very much. Honorable members, so, I've already given a reading on this, and then we'll follow up on it. Questions, statements, and petitions. In the absence of any questions, statements, and petitions, prior to the suspension of the House to refresh members, I want to use this opportunity to accordingly and respectfully invite Mr. Ahianu to speak to us as co-founder of this house.
Quite a difficult moment. on Parliament has started from a certain point, even to the change of name, until we have gotten to this very point. Yes, it's just unfortunate that I have not been in the same physically for all this time. But today I had to really squeeze everything possible and schedule for this meeting. And so I find it very important to be here. More so, UNIP Parliament gives us the opportunity to digest some national issues, and probably it gives us also the opportunity to exhibit our leadership qualities, give us the opportunity to practice what is being practiced in the main parliament. It gives us the opportunity for some sort of exposure. And then, above all, it gives us the opportunity to network. Yes, some persons here are not from Whole Technical University. Yeah, we have people from EPUC, and then nurses training, whole nurses training, we have UHAS. So this is the moment, this is the point, that we network. I keep telling people that your network is your network. How much you are wealthy depends on how networked you are. Today, on all the days, we say who you know, but today it's not only who you know, it is who you know and who knows you. Because you may know me, any girl, I mean, you may know me, and then maybe if I occupy a very beautiful position somewhere in some organization or even a government institution, you may just say, oh, I know him, any girl. But does he know you? That's the question. And what is the network among the two of you? Can you just walk to the office and as much as you recognize him, he also recognizes you? That's only at that point where you are sure and certain that every opportunity will not elude you. So, as we find ourselves over here, I think that it should be a very primary reason to network. Most of the times we take the network at this level lightly, and which is not supposed to be so. When we flash back to our current parliament, a lot of the people in parliament have been colleagues before. Our energy minister, Napo Matthew Poku Premier, he was a senior to the former foreign minister's sister, who is now the member of parliament for the Utu Senior West, Honorable Gisela Tete. They were both at tech together. They were both at tech. And she was a senior to him. He was a senior to her. And so today you can walk to the office and you can walk to his office and you know, we have those things. When you go to Lagos, we have the traditional house with the tents that are defined themselves. We have vandals and then one of you. And so when you meet somebody, you say be late, but you say sharp. So if you go to an office and somebody says be late and you also respond sharp, you are giving that opportunity to go through. And so let us not see this only as a platform to come and show. Maybe a language or a word, some words that we have learned, or yeah, the prowess of our speaking, or how well we look. It should not only be a platform to explain all these things. As much as possible, they are important, because whatever you do not practice, you cannot expect to be an expert in it. And so whatever you practice, you pretend you become that person. And so, UNIP Parliament is glad to have all of you on board, right from leadership to every single member of UNIP Parliament. I would also want to say that let us use the opportunity very well. I was hearing a couple of issues with respect to funding and then membership and what. responsibility to you in Parliament to make sure that one way or the other we are meeting the problems of you in Parliament. Yes, realistically, some of us over here, I mean some of you, may not be able to have adequate funding to support massively, but you may have a way of bringing just a colleague, just a classmate, just a student who is interested in even politics or non-partisan politics to come here and then discuss. I think that the House is not a biased House. If you would attest to the fact, Mr. Speaker gives the opportunity to everybody who is willing and ready to express him or herself. And so, even when you come here, you are given the opportunity to join either the majority focus or the minority focus. Then that is a beautiful opportunity so that you can also express yourself. I even think this should be the platform for a lot of students to take advantage of, because this is a platform where you are not going to be maybe held accountable for any mistake you may do, you may make in the House. And like maybe when you go to the main SRC Parliament, you misbehave and then you are asked to exit the House and what have you. You are fine and what have you. But over here, you can just use this as a rehearsal ground for you, so that once you go there, you are already expecting the game. For me, I always tell people that I have not been an expert of public speaking. I was not born to just speak public. I was not born with it. I was once a shy person. But you need to get to the point where, you need to get to the point where you put away all these posters. Take your destiny into your own hands and then push for it. When I was in HGU, first year, first semester, I was actually the only person, the only first year student who was able to speak in General Assembly by then, not in our Parliament. When you flash back to the minutes book of General Assembly of SRC, you may hardly find a first year student at the time. And so a lot of people thought I was a final year student. But the first time I rose to speak and even introduce myself, I said my name is, I acknowledge the chair, the old sister who was the chairman. So I acknowledge the chair in the Caucus House, and then I introduced myself, I mentioned my full name, and I was representing my hostel at the time of my hall. And instead of mentioning my house name, I mentioned a female hall's name.
Mario Hostel.
Mario Hostel. Exactly. I mentioned Mario Hostel. And Mario Hostel was a ladies' hall. I don't know if now he's still a lady for the ladies. It's mixed now. Yeah. I don't know. So this should be a platform for us to learn, to unlearn and relearn. So implement it. If we leave and leave the back parliament is not there, then it means we start as something that we can sustain it. And who were the members, especially those of us who are holding leadership positions in the House now? It's more pressure on you for you to even make this sustainable. Because tomorrow, a lot of you will be in the public space. Some of you will be going from parliamentary seats in your constituency. Some of you will be holding ministerial positions, deputy ministerial positions, appointments. And people will come as far back. We have a video about it. When it's posted, after 10 years, you may think you have lost the video. But there are people who are expecting, saving things for memories. Tomorrow, they will come and replay what I'm saying today. And they will compare to us. What maybe in future, maybe 20 years to come, if I have the title Honor or His Excellency attached to my name, or maybe Ambassador or whatever, they will come. They will say, when you were speaking as a co-founder at Youth Impact Parliament on February 20th Sunday in Hotel Kuka University, you said this, why is this contract? Today we can all attest to the fact that a lot of our politicians are reminded of things that they said that they are even contrary to. And so please, I think that I would advise each and every one of us to be very intentional about all our actions today, because if you are not careful, tomorrow you may be laughing at the wrong side of your life. For me not to bother you with a long talk, I would want to say that you, the Pan Parliament, is here to stay. And we need you, we need each and every one of us to be able to make it possible. We cannot just make it possible by words of mouth, by rhetorics, but we need to act and support our words to make them possible. Please, as much as possible, there are a couple of things that we would have to be correcting from time to time. Code of conduct by here, our dressing, yes, and what have you. Yes, our proceedings, how the proceedings go, how we come in right to speak, how we use the international signs and what have you. I think that we will all have to continually learn them so that once you rise to speak, nobody will be quick to find you or to put you to a point of order. God willing, at least you are masters of putting people to order. The moment you rise to speak and you feel the people to come, you will see another Elder is calling for point of order and you have to see that. And sometimes it's intimidating, because if you are put to order one or two occasions, by the time you realize, your faith has dropped to zero, and so you will not want to rise to speak. But please, this is a small number. This is a small number. And so please, this is where you can practice it, so that once you get the bigger numbers, you just remind yourself of an opportunity like this, and then you do the best. So please, and please, I wish us all the best, and then let us commit ourselves to making Youth Impact Parliament the very best. There are other impact parliaments out there, but this is ours, and we need to make it better ourselves. We cannot make it better if we are not deliberate about it. We need to be intentional about it. Let us endeavor to rotate, at least we, in the coming days, we consider rotating the meetings at the various campuses around, so that we can have other people participating, say, UMass, NTC, and what have you. And so please, there are more things that I always ask in the Youth Impact Parliament. Don't be in a haste to leave. Stay with us and enjoy every bit of it. I challenge you all to make the Youth Impact Parliament better than we came to make it. Thank you very much.
coming. We are really privileged to have you. Even in addition as our co-founder. And our members, in order for you to properly digest all he has given you, and an honorable round of motion for a 10-minute suspension of the House in order to see to the human anatomy and the perpetuation of all the evidence that we've given to you in that evidence. Majority leader.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I respond to the acting majority leader for that response. I rise to move a motion to the House to go on recess for 10 minutes. Thank you.
Suspension.
Suspension for 10 minutes.
Thank you. Minority leader.
Thank you very much, the Speaker and the House. The name is Erasmus. Mr. Speaker, in line with the motion moved by the acting majority leader, I rise to second. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Honourable members, motion moved and suspended. Motion moved and seconded for the suspension of the House 10 minutes. I now put the question to the House. All honourable members in favour say aye.
Aye.
Not in favour say nay. The ayes have been the motion carried. Therefore, this House is only suspended for 10 minutes.
How many minutes? 56. So make you finish. I will make it 1 hour.
I want to reach.
Have you the video cast? Okay.